watching BPD-TV.
Good afternoon. Today is Monday, January 28th, 2013. I'm Sergeant Eric Kowalczyk, and this is your daily update. We begin this broadcast with exciting news on our fight against illegal guns. Detectives from the Southern District Drug Enforcement Unit executed a search and seizure warrant in the 400 block of Freeman Street. The investigation was centered on a drug trafficking organization. To the surprise of the detectives, a total of 21 handguns, shotguns, and assault rifles were found inside the location. All the weapons were fully loaded, and fortunately what could have been a dangerous situation was peacefully resolved. 62-year-old Michael Swigert and 35-year-old Stephen Bennett of the 400 block of Freeman Street are facing more than 55 combined weapons and drug trafficking charges. This was excellent work by the Southern District Drug Enforcement Unit. We are now pleased to be joined by Lieutenant Rob Morris of our Criminal Intelligence Section. Lieutenant, thank you for being with us here today.
My pleasure, Sergeant.
Tell me a little bit about the Criminal Intel Section and what you all do.
The Criminal Intelligence Section is currently underneath the Criminal Investigation Division. We are a group of sergeants, detectives that are responsible for providing the police commissioner in command with timely and accurate intelligence to support the direction and control of the agency. That's our primary mission. Some of the units that fall under the Intelligence Section are the Gang Intelligence Unit. We have partnerships with our federal agencies and the FBI and Homeland Security Investigations. We have our City Watch unit, which is responsible for monitoring all the crime cameras throughout the city. We have a Cyber and Electronic Crimes unit, which does investigations, internet-based investigations, and things along those lines. And we also have the Criminal Intelligence Watch Center.
Sounds like you guys have a lot of things that you're focused and monitoring.
Lots of moving pieces.
What's the Watch Center?
The Watch Center is a room that's the ninth floor of the police headquarters building. It is a fusion center for the city for all intents and purposes. It's a room that is staffed 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. We do case support for all investigative units within the department. We monitor some Homeland Security related cameras throughout the Inner Harbor area for domain awareness, so we kind of know what's coming into the harbor. excuse me. We run background checks on individuals. We have a lot of detectives that do a lot of analytical work for different incidents that may occur throughout the city to kind of link cases together, per se, if we had to. And we also do a lot of stuff to monitor some of the crime trends that are occurring within the city.
So you're taking real-time information and analyzing it as it's coming into you?
Yes. Part of our responsibility in the Watch Center is to take all the data that kind of comes into the police department and put it into a working format, actionable intelligence for the officers on the street.
And you said that you do case support. So what does that mean for the detectives on the street?
We'll do background investigations on suspects or victims, primarily suspects in their cases. What we try to do is if someone happens to be the victim of a violent incident and they're associated with a certain group of people, what we try to do is forecast who their associates are, who may be a next potential victim, who may be a person that would possibly commit a retaliatory act of violence to get ahead of the incident before it occurs.
So it sounds like you all are actively engaged in the crime fight even if you're not out on the street.
That's correct.
Now, a lot of our viewers at home and across the internet might be wondering if they had information, because there are eyes and ears out on the street, if they should be calling you with that information. Is that the best place for them to go?
Sure. They can call the police department. They can always call 311 and report information. Or there's a couple different lines that are actually set up. You can call Metro Crime Stoppers. Or you could also call if someone were to have information, for example, for narcotics information throughout the city. You can call 410-666-DRUGS and provide that information as well.
Great. All of the information that Lieutenant Morris was talking about in terms of contact information is available on our website at baltimorepolice.org. Remember, you can follow the Baltimore Police Department on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, keywords Baltimore Police. You can watch past episodes of this program on our website, baltimorepolice.org, or you can watch a rebroadcast of this program every night on Baltimore City's cable channel, TV 25. For BPD-TV, with Sergeant Tony Smith behind the scenes, special guest Lieutenant Rob Morris, I'm Sergeant Eric Kowalczyk wishing you all a safe day.